Uruk-Hai Phalanx. They were the mightiest force in the Middle-earth. Carrying extremely long pikes reaching 6 meters, they advanced towards their enemies, forming a dense formation. Nearly every enemy approaching from the front was vanquished by their tightly packed pike heads. They possessed the ability to sustain the front line longer than any other unit. However, they had vulnerabilities as well. Just like a hedgehog's exposed belly, their flanks and rear were notably weak points. Moreover, lacking shields, they suffered significant damage from projectile weapons like bows. The army of Isengard deployed skirmisher units in the vanguard, using them as meat shields against arrows. While their skirmishers harassed the elven archers, their main force was able to advance as close as possible.
Ah!
army of Isengard is aiming to secure victory from the left flank. They deployed a larger number of troops in their left rear. And they also aim to prepare for enemy flanking attacks, targeting the sides of the phalanx unit. However, the elves did not engage in any flanking maneuvers. Since the Uruk-Hai phalanx unit did not easily crumble, they chose to allocate additional forces to the frontal assault. They also believed that by concentrating more firepower from their archers on the flanking units conducting maneuvers, they would be able to adequately respond. But, as soon as the Isengard army realized that there were no enemy forces attempting to flank them, they decided to mobilize their left reserve. Now is the time for them to unleash their devastating left punch.
Nasty.